truly. I'm gonna do it for you. Maud, what you think? The light can be humanized in my brain and my heart. To anyone who might care.
What do you want from me?
I had a dream.
I want him to love me so deeply I'm not afraid to show him how ugly I can be.
I had a dream.
I want him to show me scars.
I got everything I wanted.
But I don't want him to make them go away.
And if I'm being honest, it might have been a nightmare.
To
anyone who might care.
Your word is utilized as unique manifestation so someone's soul can be saved, rescued, and delivered. Dear Lord, we ask that you allow the Christian believer to gain and matriculate through life by allowing them to have everything that they want and need in their lifetime. Dear Lord, we just want to forever praise your holy and divine name. In the name of Jesus, we pray and we thank you, Heavenly Father. Amen. So it is essential for the Christian believer to analyze and examine the vicissitudes of life. And when we start to really study the Word of God, it is our duty to understand that in order for us to know and receive everything that we want and need in our lives, is that we must be true followers of Christ. Therefore, please turn with me today to 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 5, and we're actually going to be reading that from the New International Version. Once again, that's 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 5, New International Version, and it reads as thus: For in him you have been enriched in every way with all types of speech and with all knowledge. And we can also read that from the New King James Version. And it reads as thus, that in everything ye are enriched by him in all utterance and in all knowledge. Now we're going to be utilizing a corresponding verse as well today. So please turn with me to Psalm chapter 24, verse 1. Once again, that's Psalm chapter 24, verse 1. And we're going to read that from the New International Version. And it says, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. So when we start to really study the word of the Lord and we're analyzing the vicissitudes of life and we want things from the Lord. See, everything that we want, we can receive from the Lord as long as the Christian believer is obedient to his holy and divine word. So when we start to really analyze 1 Corinthians 1 verse 5, we have to understand what exactly is going on. Now see, now Paul adds that God's grace to these Christians in Corinth included being made rich in Christ in all speech and all knowledge. The word speech is used here and may refer to speaking in tongues by the power of the Holy Spirit, something Paul will deal with at length later in this letter, or may have in mind the idea of speaking well, being able to express ideas about Christ clearly and articulately. Such skill in communication was highly valued in the Greek and Roman culture during that day. And in addition, by God's grace in Christ, the Christians in Corinth have been made rich in knowledge. So when we really start to understand this, we understand that in order for us to get everything that we want from Christ, we must have two things. We must have a succinct understanding and wisdom, knowledge, and understanding from the Lord so we can implement his holy word in our society today. See, Paul's letter to the Christians in Corinth begins with thanks for the great and powerful gifts God has given to them by his grace through their faith in Christ. So if you want everything that you want in life, or if you want to receive everything that you need in life from God, that comes with God's grace and mercy. That comes with obedience to God's word. It says they will stand blameless before God in the end. Right now, though, they must stop dividing themselves according to the Christian teacher they follow and become unified and around Christ. The gospel message of Christ's death on the cross is weak and foolish to the world, but God has given faith in Christ to those who believe and find God's power and wisdom. So when we start to really analyze this, we must understand that in order for us to really matriculate, in order for us to really start receiving the blessings and the miracles that we want in our lifetime, is that we've got to understand that it's God's grace and God's mercy that will allow us to start receiving everything that we want and need in our lifetime. It says, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 4 through 9 is about God's grace to the Corinthians. Before the beginning to address problems in the church, Paul first declares his thanks to God for the people. Specifically, he is thankful for God's grace and the good gifts God has given to them. Those gifts confirm that the Corinthians are truly in Christ. This means Christ will sustain them all the way to the end because they are in Christ who has paid for their sin with his blood. They will stand blameless before God on the day of the Lord. So every time that you are out there in the world and you're looking for things that you want, maybe you're that individual right now that wants a special financial blessing. Maybe you're that individual right now that wants a special deliverance from some type of illness that you're going through in your life. Are you sick and afflicted? Have you been really come down with the COVID-19 and you're on your sick bed right now? Or maybe you're that person who doesn't know how to socialize in society. And everybody looks at you as a pretentious individual. Everybody looks at you and says that person causes a lot of strife and dissension. And that person likes to argue. And nobody really wants to be around you. See, God says, I am here. I am ready to deliver you from all of these things. I am ready to set you free because whatever God does for you in your life, if you want God's grace and mercy, if you want everything that you want in life, then you've got to hasten to God's throne so he can throw out his blessings and his miracles in your life. See, God is not going to bless you if you're being disobedient to his holy and divine word. So if you want everything that you want in life, you've got to be obedient. You've got to be a child of God. You've got to be able to be that person who can go out and spread the word of the Lord in a sophisticated manner and allow God to start blessing you with all of the miracles that are bestowed upon your life. But if you're not obeying God, if you're not being a child of God, then he's not going to do what he said he would do because you're not doing what you're supposed to do. God says, I am here to deliver you. I am here to set you free from whatever financial troubles that you're going through, from whatever troubles that you're going through on your job. If you want these things, if you want everything that you want in your life, then you've got to obey God. I feel a person right now that needs a breakthrough. I feel a person right now that wants all the sin and the wickedness gone from their lives. I feel a person right now that wants that new house. I feel a person right now that wants that new car. I feel a person right now that wants to have a better relationship with their family. I feel a person right now that wants to get rid of alcoholism. I feel a person right now that wants to get rid of drugs in their life. I feel a person right now that wants to break through, and they want everything that they want in life, but everything that God has comes from our Lord. So if you want everything you want in your life today, if you want those blessings, if you want those miracles, if you want all that strife and dissension to really cease in your life, then you've got to obey God. You've got to listen to the Lord. See, it's really simple. When you start breaking down the word of the Lord, you've got to just be obedient. See, obedience is better than sacrifice. And as we go to our correlating scripture, in Psalms 24:1, New International Version, it says, a psalm of David, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who lives in it. And I really like the King James Version as well. It says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. See, when we start really analyzing that scripture, everything in the world and the human beings and all these materialistic things belong to the Lord. So if you want that breakthrough, if you want those insurmountable blessings that you can't even fathom how they are really coming into your life, you've got to be obedient. If you want everything from the Lord, if you want everything to start being peaceful in your life, hasten to God's throne and allow God to start manifesting in your life today. Thank you.